In this video, I will show you how to use the Denise Audio Bed Tape plugin to make your music sound good. I'm Marlon and this is the White Noise Studio. Let's start with the description of Denise Audio of the Bed Tape plugin.
The Denise Audio Bed Tape is an audio mangler. It's meant to make your audio sound bad. A raw, wonky tape hammer that causes crackling, detuning and buzzing until it stops and breaks. We emulate extreme tape artifacts.
And man, does it sound bad. You know, I like to review stuff which actually improves your recording, mixing and mastering. Sure, you can use the Bed Tape plugin to make your music sound bad. But that is easy and almost a gimmick. Why not use this plugin to actually make your music sound better? To demonstrate Bed Tape, I will use the loop you are hearing right now in the background. And I will let you hear how you get from this to this. Firstly, let's quickly go over the dials and sliders with the drums in solo. This plugin does not have the small font issues I had with God Mode and Punisher. It's nice. The GUI is as small as ever. Here is the input gain. And here is the output gain. The mix control mixes the dry signal with the processed signal in the plugin. Put it back to 50. The color lets you apply a warm or bright character to the Bed Tape effect as a whole. The saturation lets you subtle drive the signal as if you were increasing the volume on a tape machine. The speed lets you control the speed of the wow, shake and squeal features. And then we have these sliders over here. Wow lets you slowly detune the signal in a pseudo-random manner. This will be more obvious with a pad. Shake also lets you quickly detune the signal in a pseudo-random manner. And then we have hiss, which lets you add a tape-like hiss white noise signal. White noise, always good. Here's the squeal, which adds you a high-pitched tape reel squeal signal. And harm applies a subtle bit-crushing signal to the signal. Well, not really a subtle bit-crush. And you have to detune on. Which slows down the signal in real time as if you press the tape with your finger. These are the basic controls. Now let's apply them on this loop. Here's the loop with every Bed Tape plugin disabled. And let's start with the synth lead. It sounds pretty okay like this, but with the Bed Tape it sounds like this. And what I did is I increased the saturation to 100 and I reduced the color to make it a bit darker, and I had to compensate with the output gain. The harm is 200 and the squeal has been reduced. This adds more beef and more guts to the synth sound. Let's continue with the bass. And there I did basically the same. Here it is. There's shakers enabled to add some interest and some movement to the bass sound. And the harm is dialed up to 40. If I turn it all the way up, it will add white noise too, which is too much for this sound. So I'll dial it back to 40 again. The mix is 100 and saturation also 100. And I played with the speed. Here's the synth pad, which is a basic massive pad. I used Bed Tape and automation to add excitement and movement to the sound. I used automation to enable the detune knob and make sure it was released right in time to create this interesting pitch bend effect. and I used the shake, his squeal even, and the hum to add a lot of movement and saturations to thicken it up. If I increase the wow, it will be too much. And I also actually added a little bit of compression and a delay. And as you can hear, the compression is sidechained by the bass drum. But it has nothing to do with the bad tape. And here are the drums in solo. I used two instances of bad tape, as you can see. This is actually the boomboxed cranked preset. I was playing around with presets and I found this one and I liked it very much. For some reason, it says default over here, I don't know why, but it is the boombox cranked preset. And I was playing around more and I thought, let's add a second instance. And in this one, I fully turned up the harm knob. And a bit of saturation, a bit of color to shape the drum sound even more. This harm dial is a hefty one. It reminds me somewhat of the plasma pedal of Game Changer Audio. That one also destroys the audio in such an extent that it also gates the audio in a very pleasant way, as you can hear now on these drums. It makes the drums really dirty, but also tightens it up in such a way which makes it really slamming. And with the rest of the music turned on, it sounds tight and punchy. Let's do that. Like I said in my FabFilter Saturn 2 on drums, in solo it can sound too much, but in a mix it can be just right. Like here. As you could hear, the Bad Tape plugin is perfectly capable of making music sound good. Bad Tape. Thank you for watching this review of the Denise Audio Bad Tape plugin. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!